HAZOP identifies risks, but how do we ensure those risks are mitigated effectively? The answer lies in linking HAZOP to SIL and LOPA. Welcome back to Oil and Gas Insights with Engineer Tasadduque. In today's video, we're diving into the advanced connection between HAZOP, SIL, and LOPA tools that form the backbone of process safety. You'll learn how to practically link these methodologies for optimal safety and compliance in your projects. After completing a HAZOP study, the next logical question is, are our safeguards sufficient, and how reliable are they? This is where SIL and LOPA come into play. If you're designing or operating oil and gas facilities, understanding these linkages can mean the difference between safe operations and catastrophic failures. Here's how these processes work together. HAZOP identifies hazards and deviations. LOPA quantifies the associated risks and evaluates the effectiveness of protection layers, and HAZOP identifies the associated risks and evaluates the effectiveness of protection layers, and HAS runs the reliability of the critical safeguards. HAZOP identifies hazard, for example, overpressure, while LOPA evaluates layers like alarms, relief valves, and shutdown systems. The goal is to close the risk gap identified during HAZOP using quantified and validated safeguards. Let's take an example of a natural gas compressor station with a high pressure scenario. During HAZOP, a deviation of high pressure is identified due to potential valve failure, leading to catastrophic equipment failure. LOPA analyzes the current layers of protection: a pressure relief valve, operator response to high pressure alarms, and an emergency shutdown system. Relief valve, risk reduction factor RRF of 10. Alarm response RRF of 10. Combined RRF 100. The residual risk, however, still exceeds the tolerable level. A SIL-2 safety instrumented system, SIS, is recommended, providing an additional RRF of 100 to meet safety standards. All AIS probes should be clearly documented to feed into LOPA analysis, ensuring no hazard is overlooked. ACIS-II probe LOPA results guide the determination of SIL requirements, ensuring cost-effective and compliant design. SIL verification should include testing and maintenance strategies to sustain reliability over the life cycle of the asset. The process requires seamless collaboration between process engineers, safety specialists, and operators to ensure alignment. Here are advanced tips for link these all three. Use software tools to integrate HAZOP, LOPA, and SIL analyses for efficiency and traceability. Perform periodic reviews of HAZOP and LOPA outcomes as plant conditions or regulations change. Consider risk-based prioritization to allocate SIL levels effectively, avoiding unnecessary costs. A common challenge is underestimating human error in LOPA, leading to flawed SIL assignments. Ensure realistic assumptions during LOPA studies. HAZOP, LOPA, and SIL are not standalone activities. They are interdependent steps in a robust safety management system. Together, they ensure risk is managed systematically and effectively. If you're already conducting HAZOPs, linking them to LOPA and SIL is the logical next step to enhance safety and reliability. If this video helped clarify the connection between HAZOP, SIL, and LOPA, let us know by hitting that like button and sharing it with your colleagues. Subscribe to Oil and Gas Insights for more advanced content. From Engineer Tasadduque. And let us know in the comments what topics you'd like us to cover next. Until next time, stay safe and keep innovating.